It's so exciting to be here with this summit. I wanted to gather all of the folks that I learn a lot from, going way back to Andrew Eng, who actually got me into programming. We've gathered some of my favorite minds, including my mom. Where are you, mom? And Sven, how are you doing, Sven? Very good. But before we started, I wanted to go back to, like, why did I get into this in the first place? And when I got into programming, I was so obsessed with this idea that you could build tools for humans, that you could write code once, execute that on millions of computers to augment human capability. But this wasn't a very new idea. This idea was 50 years old, and it all really started with Douglas Engelbart. One day, Minsky, Engelbart run into each other in the MIT corridors. Minsky is telling Engelbart about all of the fantastic things he will teach computers to do. He'll make them intelligent, he'll even make them conscious. To which Engelbart replied, "You're going to do all of that for machines. What are you going to do for humans?" And this was the very core premise of Douglas Engelbart's research. If we could augment human capability and make humans far more capable, we could solve all of the world's problems. And that takes us to the Sana team. At Sana, we wanted to gather the very best designers on the planet, researchers and engineers, to reimagine how people share and access knowledge. This team has written the next chapter in our story, and I can't wait to put it into your hands. Please meet Sana AI. Sana AI is our latest product, and it's an AI assistant trained on both all of the world's knowledge, but particularly all of your company's knowledge and all of your knowledge. We hope that will enhance your capabilities, and where that really starts is with Sana's search. Sana's search is a semantic search bar, meaning that it deeply understands your query. So you can just put in your question in natural language, it will search through every last email, Slack message, Google Drive presentation, and find the answer for you. But it doesn't just search that data. Sana AI can listen in to your meetings, record summaries, so the next time you wonder what was said in the last meeting, you can search for it and get to the millisecond where it was discussed. You can also query data with Sana, which is pretty cool. I like to think about it a bit like having 100 really, really, really small BCG consultants in your pocket. And we've also taught it to do actions. So we've taught it to use software. So when you want to complete pretty messy actions that take hours to complete, next time you can just write that query to Sana. It will understand your intent and complete that action for you. So in summary, Sana is this AI assistant that searches across all of your company's knowledge, can query data, complete actions for you. And I thought I would do the very risky thing of doing a live demo. Let's get started. So we just launched Sana AI, and I might be very interested in, you know, compile the key metrics for Sana AI. I'll just ask the assistant to gather this data. Sana will go through all of this data across various sources, query it, and summarize it here for me. But once I've asked this question, now I just have the raw data. So when I have the raw data, I might want to understand the trends, the type of stuff the BCG consultants will tell you. Trends in the data. See what it comes up with. Nice. So Sana now is crunching the numbers, coming up with the key trends, and summarizing that for me. So we just added some new investors, which we're really excited to have on board in the Sana journey. And I thought I might want to give them an update on how all of these things are going. So I could say, could you write an email summarizing our progress to our new investors, Scott, Philip, and Luke. See what it comes up with. Pretty good email. Nice. Hassan is now drafting the first draft. Maybe I'll go back, change some edits. But it hopes that Scott, Philip, and Luke will find this email well. See what else it writes. Talks about assistant effectiveness, integration, adoption, a lot of the very core points of Sana AI. That's a fantastic email. Thank you, Sana. That is actually pretty good. Better safe than sorry. Yeah, now I know that I won't be the first person the AGI goes after. So that was one example where it was querying data, summarizing that, and writing an email for me. But I thought I'd also show you how actions look. So in Sana, let's say we onboarded a new employee. We might want to translate the sign onboarding to Japanese. Here, Sana understands the intent of my query. And all I have to do to convert this entire course to Japanese is tell it to do it, and it will translate the course for me. I can open this. I actually used to live in Tokyo, but my Japanese is pretty poor. But here we have the entire thing in Japanese. So it's really powerful how you can combine a range of these different models to solve pretty advanced tasks. And this is something that would have taken probably weeks historically. But let's say we've been planning this event. I want to go back to what were actually the action points. So I can search for action points, Sana AI Summit. As you can see, it goes through every last email, every Slack message, and so on. And it can even take me directly to the meeting where this was discussed. So now Sana's taking me to the email or the meeting summary. And it's actually taking me to the exact second where that topic was discussed. It's also providing me with an overall summary of what the key objectives are, what was discussed during the meetings, etc. But now, actually, I want to understand what are Joel's action points, just to make sure I've done my job correctly. Very good. It's now capturing all of my action points for the event, and I can even ask it to just complete them for me. Awesome. Let's bring back the slides. The Sana team, you can breathe out now. It's really the fine folks up there that deserve this applaud. And like historically, we've been talking hypothetically about the productivity gains that we'll get from this. We think that, you know, if you can augment humans and make them more productive with AI, what will actually be the productivity gains? And now, since the launch of these AI-augmented approaches, we've seen a few studies published. This was the first study coming out of MIT, where they saw that on general business tasks, the people that were AI-augmented were completing the tasks in 30% less time while improving the quality of the results. They were also happier because the tasks that they had to do historically were pretty mundane, gathering data, etc. If we take another example, which is from sales, the sales reps that were AI-augmented ended up selling 2 times more. It's pretty incredible. They could also answer 2.3 times more questions than those that weren't. And a final example going to engineers, where the AI-augmented engineers could complete the tasks in 55% less time. Very cool. And I just want to set some context here. When they deployed the steam engine into factories, the productivity gains of that was 25%. Already with just the very early examples of AI, we're seeing productivity gains from 30 to 50%. And what we're passionate about at Sana is, how can we augment human intelligence? If you think about the computer was a bicycle for the mind, what happens when we can develop airplanes? What happens when we can augment humans to go out and solve the world's most pressing problems? So thank you for all of our customers that's continuing to push us. And also thank you to Sana for writing this speech.